celebration of the concluding Eucharist, which will be presided over by our Archbishop Salvatore Fisichella, is to give a bit of synthesis. Alam mo ang hirap ng synthesis. Mas madali pang magtanim ng mga holes na yun. There is always a danger for the one synthesizing to repeat everything that transpired. And you do not want that. And I don't want that either. Another temptation is for the synthesizer to produce another talk, an original talk, which has nothing to do with all the things that have transpired. And I don't want to do that.
Thank you.
So I ask the Lord to help me. And I'm sure you are high and tired. You will be kind, and in your tiredness, probably you will not see the mistakes. First of all, I would like to thank everyone who has participated in this CCME forum. The speakers, the facilitators, everyone. Each one has a role to play, and you really play a role. And I just hope that I will be able to bring your experience and your contribution to this synthesis. I was trying to find a way of doing this presentation. And what prevailed over me was to use images rather than concepts, and images from the Bible. So I have here three major images, which I hope could capture the experience of PCME 4, of communion, one heart and soul. The first image that I would like to use comes from the Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 2, 1 to 5. And it is the image of opening roofs. Pagbubukas ng bubong. In Mark 2, Jesus returned to Capernaum, and people learned that he was at home. Many gathered, and because of the number of people, there was no more room for some people. Not even at the door. Punong-puno ng tao yung bahay, yung mga gusto pang pumasok, wala na. Hindi na makapumabuksan ang pintuan. And inside the house, Jesus preached to them. There were people who were bringing a paralytic. There were four men who carried the paralytic. Alam niyo yung kwento, no? Yes. Unable to get near to Jesus through the door, wow, they opened up the roof. New evangelization as opening roofs so that they could lower the paralytic in front of Jesus. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Child, your sins are forgiven." During these past 3 days, I have seen roofs being opened so that we could be brought near Jesus. Ang daming bubong na binuksan para maibaba tayo mapalapit kay Jesus. You know, we normally enter the house through a door. Ilan sa inyo ang umuwi sa bahay na dumadaan sa bubong? How many enter your house by entering through the roof? You know, the roof is a piece of the house to protect the dwellers, to protect the dwellers from the elements, from extreme heat, and also from water rain. So you need a roof, a sturdy roof, to protect yourself. The roof is necessary as a shield, but it is not the normal entry to a house. Who entered the house through a roof? Sino? Yung husband na hindi nagpaalam sa misis na gagabihin siya. The husband who promised to be home at dinner but failed to show up might pass through the roof out of fear. A seminarian. Who comes home? Kawain ko kasi. A seminarian who goes beyond the, how do you call that? The curfew, yes. Or the novice mistress. Who did not ask permission from the novices. Opening roofs to enter is not normal. It is unexpected. But in the fullness of time, the roof of the earth opened. The clouds were parted, and the Holy One, the Just One of God, descended. The roof opened by God so that His communion with us will be complete. St. Paul calls it in the letter to the Philippians, the self-emptying of Jesus. The Son of God coming in a very ungodly, undivine form as a humble human being. He came in this unexpected, even unnormal way of crashing through the roof so that heaven and earth would become one. And the heavens opened again, the roof opened again at the baptism. And the voice from above said, "This is my Son." The roof opened again in the Transfiguration. The roof opened again when Jesus died. And it will remain open for all of us in His resurrection. The roof be opened by God. These 3 days, I have experienced many wounds in open. Yes, it is God who first opens the roof so that we could be in communion with us. But there were many stories and testimonies during these past days of us being lowered by Jesus so that we could be close to other people. Sometimes we are the paralyzed people. We don't want to move. Ay, mahusay ang Diyos. Biglang bubukas ang bubong at tayo ang ibinababa. So that we could be near people. Si Sister Mary Jane, bumukas ang pinto. Bumaba siya. Ibinaba siya sa mga indigenous people. And with them, gapang siya sa lupa. Kapag nagpatali na. Si Dimples. Oh, si Dimples. Na mukhang hindi lamang ang roof ang bumukas. Talaga, ang puso niya bumukas at hindi na may sara ang bibig. Oh, but why prevent her from sharing? The roof has been opened. She was lowered to an experience of death. And there she found God as the meaning of her life. At her lowest point, she rediscovers faith. But we also heard stories of Jesus opening our roofs, our well-constructed roofs, our roofs that had been approved by structural engineers, at binayaran natin ng mahal na mahal, no? But Jesus will open our roofs in order to bring before us some people. Minsan, tayo ang binababa ni Jesus to face people. Other times, Jesus opens our rooms, we are surprised, and then some people come before us in a surprising way. They look like thieves, like the experience of Rodrigo. In his household, Couples for Christ household, the roof opened and dropped before him was the killer of his father. And now the killer is inside your house. You have a choice. Itapon mo kahit siya pataas or tanggapin. You are part of the family. Please continue reflecting. How did you experience these past 3 days, the opening of room? So that the just one could come to us, so that people could come to us, and so that we could be brought by Jesus where he wants us to be. Okay ho ba yun? Naiintindihan ho ba yun? Bumubukas din ang roof na aking puso. So that's the first image that I would like to use. The second image is from wandering to journeying. Another image that I would like to use is that. Wondering. Hindi yung wonder na, oh, ano ba ito? Yung wondering, yung... Ano ba sa Tagalog yan? Pagalagala, palaboy-laboy, pahalya-halya-ryan. Yeah. And I got this from an author, right? From wandering to journeying. And that brings us to a deep question. We never say life is a constant wandering. We say life is a journey. But what are we experiencing? Are we wandering or are we journeying? And I would like to say that the shift, yung pagbabago from wandering to journeying, is very often a fruit of making room for the other. St. Paul, in his second letter to the Corinthians, said, "Make room for us." Masama ang loob ninyo, mga Corinthians, sa akin. But I appeal to you, make room for us. Bago kayo mahihiya, oh, kasi hindi ko naman kayo nakikita. Diliman nyo na lang po sila. Ilan sa inyo minsan na nakakaramdam? How many of you feel sometimes that your life is not a journey but more of a wandering? Narating na. Narating pa rin. But this is part of the spirituality of the Jewish people. In Deuteronomy 26, during their thanksgiving for the harvest, they will present the fruits of the harvest to the priest in thanksgiving, and they should declare in the presence of the Lord, this is what they say, "My father was a wandering Arabian who went down to Egypt with a small household and lived there as a resident alien. But there he became a great nation, strong and numerous. When the Egyptians maltreated and oppressed us, imposing harsh servitude upon us, we cried to the Lord, the God of our ancestors, and the Lord heard our cry. The Lord saw our affliction, our trial, and our oppression. Then the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a strong hand, with terrifying power, with signs and wonders, and brought us to this place and gave us this land, a land flowing with milk and honey." From wandering to journeying. When you wander, that means you are moving without a sense of direction. Yung mga parents, siguro hirap na hirap yan. Tatanungin yung mga anak, "Oh, what do you want to eat for dinner?" "Whatever." "Oh, what do you want to have tomorrow for lunch?" "Whatever." "When do you want to have our vacation?" "Whenever." Who is your girlfriend now? Whoever. When will you grow up? It depends. What course do you want to take? But it's not only with the young, even with the not so young. We could be waking up every morning and going back to bed in the evening, and you wonder, did I journey today? Or did I just wander about? It's about losing direction. It is about the stories of Fazenda, Richardson, and Ms. De Silva. We wandered in addictions, away from family, away from school, away from a future. It was the story of those beautiful girls who played the bells, whose lives were wandering in darkness because of poverty and inequality. It was the daily wandering of the indigenous people who had no access to medicine, no access to what human life, a decent human life, was. Kahit saan ka pumunta, parang walang pupuntahan. And where you find yourself is not where you want to be. And any place else is better. But I cannot get there. How does the shift happen from wandering to journeying to a direction, to a promised land? How does God take a wandering Aramean in order to make of them or her a child of God? It is by making room for them, according to our testimonies. Making room for others. By making room for others, we become agents of God's hand, guiding those who have lost direction so that they could find their way. We find this affirmed in the three parables in Luke 15. The parable of mercy, the lost sheep. Kaya, yung mga may problema, huwag nyo na lang tatawagin ang sarili nyo na black sheep. Tawagin nyo na lang sarili nyo, wandering sheep. Parang medyo maganda-ganda. Wandering sheep. And then the lost coin. And of course, the son who wandered, lost his sense of direction, and lost his sense of being son. But in the heart of the shepherd, there is always room for the lost sheep. If you cannot come home, I will look for you, and I will carry you home. If you cannot journey, I will accompany you. I will carry you. And we will journey together. It's like the image used by Archbishop Fisichella. The landowner going to the piazza. searching for the people who are looking for direction, for work, for dignity. The shepherd goes out and looks for the sheep that has wandered away and will help it journey back home. Because in the heart of the shepherd, there is room for the sheep. Sa puso noong pastol, may buwang kahit sa tupa na sugatan at hindi makalakad. Hindi ka makalakad, papasalin kita, ilalakad kita. Ang paa ko ang magiging lost coin may be insignificant, but for that woman, it is mine. It may be insignificant to observers, but it is mine. And in my heart, it will always be mine. So I will clean the whole house. I will search for it. And the lost son. His journey back home was made complete when the Father opened the house again. This is yours. And the dignity of being a son, a child, has been restored to the son. Alam niyo, baliktad ho, kung tutusin, dapat yung anak na nagwaltas ang dapat mag-restore sa ama. He has a lot to restore to the Father. Yung yaman, yung pera, na ginastos niya. But the Father did not ask the Son to restore. The Father restored the dignity of the Son. You have room in the house. You are my son. And the wandering ends. The journey begins. Yesterday, listening to those testimonies, I said, wow, if we only have room in our hearts for many people who are wandering around, then they will take the journey, the joyful journey back. See the power of communion. See the power of making room. See how those who are afraid and are ashamed of their wandering, who now have the courage to say, I will take the journey. During the Holy Week, the Holy Thursday, evening Mass of the Lord's Supper, we invited some of those who had surrendered, drug dependents who had surrendered to the barangays and the police, and who had been, in a way, entrusted to the parishes, to the church. We invited them. One of them, before the Mass, I asked them, kamusta na kayo, kamusta? Sabi niya, wow, hindi ko alam na isang araw makakapasok ako sa bishop's house. Who am I to be here in the house of the archbishop? Ako ay hamak na tao at atin pa. And then, sabi niya, yung evidence, nag-random blood test. Negative na po ako. Hindi po ako gumagamit na ng drugs. Pwede na pala akong magbagong buhay. The wandering is now becoming a journey. At tuwang-tuwa siya na kapag kami siya sa dining room ng Archbishop of Manila. The wandering leads to this journey. PCNE4 is an invitation. Make room, especially for those who want to take the first step towards journeying, and help them with love and compassion to get out of wandering. Okay. Nag-journey pa ba tayo together o nagwa-wander-wander na kayo dyan? Mga mukhang mga wandering kayo dyan eh. Bukas na ba ito? Hindi ba? Seminary and Kamaklar? Ay, hindi ba? Kala ko gusto mo rin mag-ordain eh. Yun. So, naiintindihan pa ho ba? Nakikita niyo ba yung mga experiences doon sa sinasabi ko? Ay, boy, salamat na. Hindi ko alam paano ko tatali-taliin eh. So, yung isang image, no? Opening roofs, then from wandering to journeying. No? Make room for people and they will journey with a destination, with the direction. The third, balik tayo sa bahay. Close doors, but open wounds. Close doors, saradong pinto, but open wounds. Mga sugat na bukas. And here, I go to the 20th chapter of St. John's Gospel. The first day of that week, that resurrection week, the doors were closed. The doors were locked. Why? Why did the disciples close or lock the doors? For fear of the Jews, sabi ni St. John. Ahaha, yung matatakutin, yung punong-puno ng fear, closed doors. Closed. But then, in spite of the closed doors, the risen Lord was able to appear in their midst and greeted them with peace. And he showed them his wounds. Then he makes room for them. He invites them to be part of his mission. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. I am tempted to tell Jesus, Jesus, hindi ka pa ba nadadala? Iniwanan ka na nga ng mga yan eh. Ngayon sinasama mo na naman. But Jesus has says, as the Father has sent me, so I send you. Be part of my mission. And he gives the Holy Spirit to them because he knows them. He knows that they cannot do the mission, his mission, if left to themselves. So the spirit of communion with Jesus and the Father will be the spirit of communion with Jesus in mission. And they have a mission of reconciliation, forgiveness of sins. Sino yung absent during that apparition of the risen Lord? Sino ko? Noong nagwa-wonder, hindi ba sa inyo? Who was absent during that apparition? Amang, Thomas. Nagtudo pa yung iba nito. Si Thomas nga. No? And he said, I will not believe unless I see for myself. Well, let us not blame Thomas. Kayo ba? Maniniwala ba kayo kay Pedro? Maniniwala ba kayo dun sa mga ibang apostoles? Ako hindi. Eh, makasama ko rin yung nagsitakbuhan eh. Maniniwala ako? Hindi. Kaya mayroon, no, I want to see. And remember, Thomas said, before the miracle of the raising back to life of Lazarus, Thomas was the one who said, let us go and die with him. Handa siya mamatay. Pero pa hindi pa niya naintindihan yung muling pagkabuhay. Let us go and die with him. And then, a week later, again, the doors were closed, but Jesus appears and tells Thomas, put your finger here and see my hands. Bring your hand and put it inside my side. The doors are closed, but the wounds of the risen Lord are open. And he invites the disciples, put your hand inside my wounds. Put your hand into my side. These are open doors. Our world today is enveloped by fear. Puro takot ang mundo natin ngayon. Kanina, narinig natin yung tanong ni Ani, naranasan niyo ba ba? Have you experienced that? People just see and the mere look of you already generates fear and rejection. Ako naranasan ko yan. Si Bishop, nandito. Maghihigi yan. Hihigi ng tumesyo yan. Sarang pinta, sarang. Bakit? Mukha ba ang bong? Di ba ako mukhang tekapigay din? Ha? Yung ibang mga magulo ba? Oh, matakot lang. Ipada, matakot lang. Meron tayong word. Xenophobia. Comes from the root of Greek xenos. Xenos means stranger. A stranger. And xenophobia is fear of strangers. Fear of anyone who thinks differently from my way of thinking. Fear of anyone whose blood, whose color, whose name are unfamiliar to me. Fear. And fear, like the experience of the disciples, makes us close doors. And not only doors. Ako, bintana. May bintana na, may bakal pa. Yung bakal, may kantado pa. Minsan, nakatulog ako sa isang bahay ng mga madre. Sabi nung superior bishop, papasok ka na ba sa room mo? Oh, yes. Kasi when you enter your room, we will close the, not only the door, but the ano, yung may metal, ano? Ay, why? Ay, para safe. Eh, wala kang makakapasok. Makakalabas pa ako! Remember, ha? Closed doors prevent people from entering, but if they also prevent you from going out, how can you do mission if the doors are closed? How can you go out? It's not just protecting the house from those who will intrude, but how about you? You don't want to get out? You must be very fearful. You must really be scared. But that's happening now. That's happening. So where is Jesus directing us? Where do we find openness? Where, if the doors are closed, aha, His wounds are open. We enter the wounds of Jesus in the wounds of humanity. Those are the doors wide open. And Jesus is telling us, look and touch my wounds. This is the way of communion. In touching the wounds of Jesus, in the wounds of the world, we touch our own wounds. Maybe that is the reason why we are afraid of seeing and touching the wounds of other people. We are afraid to face our own wounds. We want to pretend, I am not wounded. Sila, wounded sila. Ako malinis, kutis. Ano nga ba? Basta, ganun. But if I enter the open doors of the wounds of other people, I am entering my own wounds. And then I see myself in them. And when I see myself, I see a brother, a sister. This wounded person could be me. He could be my father. She could be my mother. He could be my brother, my cousin. She could be my sister. She could be my friend. Entering the wounds of Jesus, present in the wounds of the world, helps us recover a sense of common humanity. We are not alien to one another. There is no stranger when it comes to woundedness. We are all one humanity. Monsignor Thomas Halleck, who was given the prestigious Templeton Prize, a theologian from Czechoslovakia, said, if you do not look at the wounds of Jesus in the wounds of the world, and if you do not touch the wounds of Jesus in the wounds of the world, you have no right to say, my Lord and my God. Was able to reach that profession of faith when he looked at the wounds and touched the wounds. And so the sense of family expands. And my family is not anymore the closed family. I can embrace others who are as wounded as I am. And we share the same wounds with creation and with people from other countries. And hopefully, through this sharing of wounds, we can learn the path of forgiveness. I was so touched when Honey, this morning, I want to share, somebody met her. A participant here of PCLE met Honey, I think downstairs, and embraced Honey and asked for forgiveness. I'm sorry, she said. We have thought ill of all the Muslims. I am sorry. We are sorry to our brothers and sisters with disabilities. If you are often forgotten, if you are often neglected, when our worldview is always dictated by our own capacities, unmindful of the wounds that we should enter. How can we forget people? Accepting the killer of his father into his household. And that was not the end of the story, pala. Meron pang pangalawang killer na napasama ulit sa kanyang household. So his family is getting expanded as his heart is getting expanded. And in his woundedness, he sees the wounds also of those who have wounded him. How I wish our parishes would enter the doors of the wounds of peoples, so that in this year of the parish, no parish becomes parochial. The word parochial means narrow. Sana in the year of the parish, no parish becomes parochial. Now every parish really becomes communion, where we open doors, where we surpass our fears, and we see a brother or sister whose wounds are my wounds too. And the wounds of creation are our wounds. Archbishop Ausa this morning talked about the mission of the church on the worldwide stage. Ang mga kapatid sa Pilipino, ngayon po ang mga Pilipino ay nasa lahat ng sulok ng mundo. One face of globalization is Filipino. Kahit sa mga lugar na hindi usok at akalain may Pilipino, may Pilipino. And so we are also being asked to open our hearts to the wounds of the world. We have our wounds in our country, but we need to also enter the wounds of our brothers and sisters in other parts of the world, in communion, solidarity with them, and hopefully effective action. Around 2 years ago, 2015, on the roof, open for me, and I was dropped in worlds that I did not expect to be dropped. I was elected president of Caritas International and also president of the Catholic Biblical Federation. At the same time, same year, two international bodies. And I felt like as we face our local needs and our local wounds, the Filipinos, and myself as Filipino and as Christian and Catholic, I mean, as to enter the wounds of other parts of the world. As Archbishop also said, I was there with him in the United Nations to talk to the representatives of the nations about caring for the environment. And when I started my talk, Archbishop Ausa left the hall. Nag-iisa na ako. Ba't umalis na siya? Nasa United Nations pa naman ako. Sanay na ako sa mga karaoke, karaoke. Sa United Nations. And then I was invited by the Food and Agriculture Organization in Rome when they had the international meeting on food security. Kung what am I doing here? Ang alam ko lang sa food, kumain. Food security, famine, drought, and all of those. But I'm being asked to enter the wounds of the earth. I was in Istanbul for the United Nations Summit for humanitarian response to disasters. And 2 weeks later, the airport was bombed. In Nigeria, I heard stories of human trafficking, especially of Filipinos. In Norcia, in Amatrice, in Italy, we visited those who survived the earthquakes in Japan. The wounds that I see in Yolanda-stricken areas, the same wounds that you see in Sendai, in Al-Madrid, in the refugee camps. But let me just give you two stories. Once I went to the U.S. in Washington, D.C., I took the airport in Virginia. My brother and cousin who met me said, wala kaming oras magluto ng lunch, so let us just eat in a nearby Vietnamese restaurant. Sige, sige, so I want to eat and then sleep. So kain kami. Yung Vietnamese soup, pho. Any Vietnamese here? Is it pho or pho? Pho. Fa, so, la, ti, do. And I was, sarap talaga. Naglalaway ako. And then, when we were about to end, we were deciding whether to have coffee or dessert. A Vietnamese woman came to our table. She introduced herself. Sabi niya, I am the owner of the restaurant. The waiters told me that there is a group of Filipinos here. Sabi niya, kasi I have instructed my employees, whenever there are Filipinos who come, call me. Yeah? I said, oh yes, we're from the Philippines. Then she said, I was one of the old people. I was one of the refugees that escaped from Vietnam. And I landed in the Philippines. I stayed in Palawan for many years. You welcomed us. You loved us. And in my little way, I want to thank the Filipino people. And she gave us free dessert. And she was a Christian, a Catholic. She saw my shirt, said, are you a priest? I said, yes, I am a Catholic. And said, I was so blessed to have landed in the Philippines. My faith was nurtured. The wounds of the people, and in those wounds, memories of love, memories of compassion, memories of being recognized as a brother or sister will remain, and they journey to new life. I visited Lebanon, one of the refugee camps. Refugees from Syria, Iraq, Afghanistan. Then I had a session with the Caritas workers, volunteers, and I saw how tired they were. Naawa rin ako sa mga volunteers kasi they see daily disaster. Every day is bleak, every day is dark. So in our session, I told them to also look for signs of hope. Huwag lang kayong magkwento ng mga problema. Let us exchange stories of hope. Yes, in the open wounds of Christ, you will find life. Tell us stories of how you found life as you enter the wounds of our brothers and sisters. And there was a fine Lebanese woman. Wow, her name, Joan Arc. Joan of Arc. She volunteered, she said, I will have a story to tell. They went to a home. The specialization of Joan Arc is caring for illegal migrants, those who are arrested and put into detention cells. And she has taken care of many Filipinos in Beirut. And she told us the story. One day, she was invited by Caritas Syria to train some people in the ministry, pastoral care of illegal migrants. So she volunteered, she went. She slept in the house of some sisters, religious sisters, and every day she would take a taxi. Yung katulad ng kwento kanina ni Eric ba, or Ernie, talagang magta-taxi ka, naka-taxi. So one day, she took a taxi, reached the place of the seminar, she asked the taxi driver, "Magkano? How much I pay?" And the driver said, "No." And she said, "No, I have money. E pera ako. I can pay you." And the driver said, "No, no, you don't have to pay." She panicked. "No. What payment will this man ask for?" So sabi niya, she was already almost screaming. "No, I have money. Accept my payment. Tell me, how much, how much?" And the driver said, "But how could I accept money from Caritas?" "How did you know that I work for Caritas?" And the man said, "3 years ago, I was in prison in Beirut. One day, I was sick. I asked for medicine. Nobody wanted to give me. You passed by. You heard me. And you gave me medicine. I was able to sleep that night. But I have not thanked you. So please, let me thank you now. 3 years in this wounded heart remained the love of Jean Paul. The face of Jean Paul has been engraved in this room. And look at how good God is. At an unexpected moment, their paths cross. A deep communion sealed in locked prisons, but open wounds where love is allowed to enter. Through them, Syria and Lebanon are born. Through the wounds of Ukon Takayama and the wounds of Lorenzo Ruiz, Japan and the Philippines, with not so happy memories, who have communion. Thanks to the wounds of martyrs, communion in wounds. Kapag sarado ang pinto, maghanap kayo ng suga. Doon, makakapasok ang pag-ibig. At sa mga suga na ating napasok ng pag-ibig, ang buhay ni Kristo ay mararanasan. I am there with the mystery of how God weaves our lives, weaves our roofs and doors. God will never stop. If the door is closed, God will open a roof. If a roof is closed, we have wounds to enter. And when we are wondering, God has a hand where the wounded could go back to the journey. And all of that together in communion, in the most unexpected ways and unexpected moments. Even a jail, even a refugee camp could be a moment of communion. But we praise God for weaving all of these, a whole. And I end with Isaiah 38, Hezekiah got sick And he had a prayer of thanksgiving for the healing that he had experienced. Those of you who pray the breviary will be familiar with this. In the noontime of life, I said, I must depart. My dwelling, like a shepherd's tent, is struck down and borne away from me. You have folded up my life like a weaver who severs me from the last thread. But you have restored my life from the pit of destruction. You have continued weaving my life with the life of other people. And that's life. That's to be fully alive, to be woven in the lives of other people. Last December 22, 2016, before Christmas, I got a mysterious letter. But let me read it. Dear Cardinal Tagle, ako po si Cynthia Cabrera, nakatira sa Payatas, Quezon City. Hindi ko po alam kung natatandaan mo pa ako. Siguro alam niya, malapit na akong mag-senior citizen. Na-interview niyo po ako last 2007. Bishop pa lang po kayo noon. At ang sabi niyo po sa akin, ay gusto mo gawan ko kayo ng stole na gawa sa scrap cloth, the rugs. Ang sagot ko po sa inyo ay, mabigat po ang ganitong tela. Pero ang sabi ninyo po, hindi naman ikaw ang magpapasan. Bakit ka mabibigatan? Parang sinabi ko ngayon. Na-challenge po ako at pinag-isipan ko kung paano ako makagagawa ng stola na mukhang rum. Last 2009, nakabuo po ako ng isang stola. Kaya lang ang problema ko ay kung paano ko ito maipararating sa inyo. Hanggang binigay ko na lamang po ito sa ibang pare. Kahapon, December 21, isang Jesuitang pare ang nagmisa sa aming kapilya. At nakita ko, ginamit niya ang istolang ginawa ko. At naikwento ko sa kanya na ginawa ko ito para sa inyo. Pero hindi ko alam kung paano ko ito ipaparating sa inyo. Ang sabi niya, sa Jescom ko ito ihahatid. Nabuhayan po ako ng loob. Hindi ko po alam kung makakaabot po sa inyo ang aking munting regalo. Sana po ay magugustuhan ninyo ito. Maraming salamat po sa inyong challenge sa akin. Akala ko, hindi ko kayang gumawa nito. Kaya ko pala. God bless po and more power. Ate Sage. Nandito si Ate Sage. Ay, si Ate Sage. Ngayon, Ate Sage, ibigay mo sa akin talaga. Maayos. Mga retaso, gawa ng mga tao, misa ng pakiramdam, mga retaso lang sila. Pero sa misa, ang mga pira-piraso tinapay na iisa kay Jesus. Kaya kita po natin ang ating kahapit, ang ating weaving na nagawa during the PCN. That's a better synthesis. Look at them. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig at pagtsatsaga. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Cardinal Tante. We also thank the weavers of Royal Rumble for bringing us the tapestry of our PCNE community as a people of God. May this image of communion remind us that we will always be of one heart and one soul.